So here in these series of short videos about Kundalini, how to be a Kundalini yogi, I want to explore with you all some of the amazing terrain and techniques and just what it means to live with an awakened Kundalini Shakti energy, how to awaken it, how to integrate it, what it means to be a Kundalini yogi and how we can walk on that path together. So just beginning with the meaning of the word Kundalini. So Kundalini overall comes from the tantric tradition, and all of the tantric tradition ideally has a balance between earth and sky, between the body, physical reality of our lives and the transcendent awareness. And this word Kundalini, the etymology of this word can be traced back to words like kunda, which means something like a pit or a cavity in which fire can sit. And also kundal and kundali, which has the sense of the coiled one, the coiled energy. And within the overall tantric tradition, there is that sense of a swift path of spiritual development, a swift path of imminence. So what we're really dealing with in Kundalini is a process, a technology for how to awaken a vital energy with that lies dormant within us, so that we can experience things as they are, so that we can become one with universal consciousness, so that we can recognize that our consciousness is one with the eternal reality of living within this amazing interconnected conscious universe. So many people who are watching this video will be familiar with the concept and the reality of the symbolic language of the chakras. Now, when I say symbolic language, I don't mean something that doesn't exist, but it doesn't just exist on the level of physical reality. If you chop up the body, you know, if you're on the if you're being in the hospital and the doctor's chopping you up, you're not going to find the chakras anywhere. So they exist on a more subtle, mental, imaginative level of reality, and they very much exist as the template through which the physical body is built energetically. So we can talk about the seven major chakras. And traditionally, the Kundalini energy is awoken primarily from the Muladhara chakra, the root chakra at the base of the spine. And for men, the nucleus of the root chakra is the perineum, the band of muscle between the anus and the sexual organs. And it is there for women as well, but for women as well, because they're built slightly differently. They don't have such a long perineum muscle. So in terms of their own practice of Mulabandha, root lock, they can also begin to explore the contraction of the vagina, as well as focusing on this perineum muscle. But you will notice, and the yogis noticed, that the perineum that sits at the base of the spine, the muscle between this anus and sexual organs, you can begin to pulse it and work it. And doing that seems to have a direct connection up with Ajna chakra, one of the higher chakras that's also connected to the pineal gland in a sense of awakening. And you can explore this within yourself. And one of the things that I'm going to be encouraging you through these series of videos about how to be a Kundalini yogi, that it's not just about reading the books, it's not just about reading the ancient texts. Your body and your experiential experience of meditation, when you go deep into yourself, is the text that you need to be able to tap into and learn. The text, the yogis, they're just pointing to the reality that you will need to discover within yourself. And these are things you don't need to believe, because that's what they say in the sacred scriptures or the texts. You can experience this within yourself. You begin to work with Mulabandha root lock, connecting to that energy of the root energy center, and you'll notice how it begins to stimulate the higher regions of the brain. I noticed that within my own practice, and you will be able to do that as well. So when we work with the lower chakras, and the lower chakras in the yogic tradition are often connected to the unconscious mind and the subconscious mind. So the process of Kundalini awakening is very much opening up the doorway, open up the doorways, the gates of the unconscious mind so that it can be integrated through consciousness, You're making the unconscious conscious, as it were, through your practice of the awakening of Kundalini energy. And it's a very powerful energy to have moving through your system, and once the doors are opened on Kundalini, you can't so easily close it again, and that's where some of the dangers can lie within Kundalini. But you can always mitigate these dangers through working in a very earnest way, being careful of your ethics, and it's similar in a way to when you take plant medicine or ayahuasca. If you're not sorted out in terms of your alignment with your soul values, your spirit, your ethics, then it can be a kind of brutal awakening through something like plant medicine. It's the same with Kundalini, so you want to be aligned and earnest and honest in your practice of Kundalini, then it'll be a smoother journey as you begin to awaken the coiled serpent Shakti energy of Kundalini. So when you're working with the chakras, you can utilize something like a triad of words, and that triad of words that I like to use are: you can charge, and then release, and then uplift. So one of the maxims that's used a lot in spirituality these days, and it's very true, is that where attention goes, energy grows, or something like that. Where your attention moves, energy grows. Awareness grows. Where your attention moves, things begin to develop. So just holding your attention on the lower chakras, on anything, will help that reality to grow. And you begin to charge the energy of the lower chakras through placing your awareness upon them, your attention upon them. And when you're working with the lower chakras, you don't need to be afraid of it. It's not going into the animal, it's not going into the underworld or some sort of brutal animal past or anything like that. You're actually beginning to tap into a primordial energy. So when you're working with the root energy center, the lower chakras in general, and connect to the energy of the hips, the buttocks, the legs, you want to have that sense of being earthed and grounded, and then things will begin to flow much more for you through your practice of Kundalini. So once you've charged up the lower chakras, then the energy can begin to release itself. Now, one of the other practices that's important within your journey into Kundalini is what we can call semen retention, or what the yogis might call holding the bindu. So the bindu, in a way, is the point through which the universe manifests, through creation manifests through bindu. So the creative energy is most held within the semen, within the sexual juices. So retaining that gives you the regenerative power that can move up through your system through the amazing awakening of Kundalini. So I've talked a little bit about the meaning of the word Kundalini. As I say, it's within the broader tantric tradition. Tantra, one way of understanding that word is the tantra, so the sense of awakening consciousness and liberating energy, freeing energy of the tra. One way to understand the word tantra. So Kundalini is an amazing practice to begin to connect to. And one of the things that you'll need to be able to handle through your process of awakening Kundalini is the balance between mythos and logos, the mythic realm and the rational, your rational mind as well. But we'll touch upon that in the second video of this series of exploration of the Kundalini yogi, how to be a Kundalini. But being a Kundalini yogi will mean having all of the different facets of your being working for the momentum of spiritual awakening in general. How you sleep is important as well, and being able to hold those liminal states between sleep and wake are incredibly important for Kundalini, as is having a pure diet, a clean diet, so you have that lots of sattvic pure energy moving through your system as well. And it's also physical exercises as well. So I'll point you to some of my other resources and courses where we have more kriyas and asanas, which will help you to awaken to the practice of the Kundalini Shakti.